There have been long-standing questions about the private sector's commitment to developing a commercial space station. Sierra Space is partnering with Blue Origin on a commercial space station concept called Orbital Reef. Creating a space station poses numerous challenges, and one of the biggest hurdles is the size of the segments. Despite advancements in modern and next-generation rocket development, fairings can only accommodate modules of a certain size, limiting the overall size of the station. However, Sierra Space has been tackling this issue by developing inflatable modules. These modules are launched at a reasonable size and then inflated once in orbit. Just weeks ago, they achieved a major milestone by successfully completing a full-scale life module test, known as the Ultimate Burst Pressure Test. This test is crucial as it represents one of the final steps before these modules are sent to space for further testing. In the coming months, we can expect more detailed information about the recent test, including the exact results, and what to anticipate as Sierra Space continues to push the boundaries of space exploration. For years now, Sierra Space has been conducting tests on the large integrated flexible environment for life in various ways. In the past, they conducted tests on smaller scale models to ensure the safety of the design. These tests involved increasing the pressure until the habitat burst, providing valuable data on its strength and breaking point. Additionally, they conducted long-duration pressure tests, where the pressure shell was kept pressurized for an extended period of time. However, just a few weeks ago, Sierra Space achieved a major milestone in the development of the first commercial space station. They successfully conducted the first ultimate burst pressure test on a full-scale life structure at NASA Marshall. The results were impressive, exceeding NASA's recommended safety levels by 27%. The full-scale unit reached a pressure of 77 psi before bursting, surpassing NASA's maximum operating pressure of 60.8 psi, which is multiplied by a safety factor of 4. In the video of the test, you can witness the fabric stretching on the left side, before the entire shell gives way and explodes due to the immense pressure. Creating a structure that is both inflatable and incredibly strong required a unique combination of materials. The restraint layer for life is constructed using high-strength soft goods materials, which are sewn and woven fabrics. Sierra Space's continuous advancements in testing and development are paving the way for the future of space exploration and habitation. With each milestone achieved, they are getting closer to realizing the vision of a fully functional and safe commercial space station. The Vectron material is truly remarkable. When pressurized, it transforms into rigid structures that are incredibly strong. In fact, under normal operating pressure, these Vectron soft goods become 5 times stronger than steel. This exceeds the safety factors required for the lifetime performance of space stations. To achieve this strength, a bladder is used to control inflation and pressurization, working in tandem with the restraint layer. Together, they create a structure that can withstand impacts from micrometeoroids and other projectiles. It's worth noting that this test specifically focused on the life habitat pressure shell and the restraint layer. The company, in collaboration with its soft goods technology partner ILCDO, has already designed and tested Vectron straps at smaller scales. This full-scale test is a significant milestone. In the future, the life habitat will be packed inside a standard 5-meter rocket fairing and inflated to the size of a 3-story apartment building once in orbit. Sierra Space, the company behind this innovation, envisions a future where just 3 launches of these modular life units can create a living and working environment in space that is larger than the entire International Space Station. As they continue to iterate and improve upon their designs, they plan to create even larger versions. For example, a 1,400-plus cubic meter version packed inside a 7-meter rocket fairing would surpass the size of the ISS in a single launch. The possibilities are truly exciting, and with this successful test, the company is one step closer to making it a reality. The big question now is, what lies ahead for the company and its hardware? As another quote from Sierra Space suggests, they are planning to build upon their successful tests. In 2024, they will kick off an ambitious testing campaign, conducting both sub- and full-scale tests. Additionally, they will be conducting a series of under-burst pressure tests. Alongside the early-stage development of the primary atmospheric barrier and micrometeoroid orbital debris layers. These exciting developments are something we can eagerly anticipate in the near future. In space, exciting plans are underway for the Orbital Reef, a commercial space station led by Blue Origin and Sierra Space. Sierra Space will provide multiple life modules for the station, making up the majority of its pressurized volume. Both companies have confirmed their commitment to the project, and plan to use the New Glenn to send up the main structure modules and uninflated life habitats. The station is expected to be fully operational later in this decade. The upcoming Life 2.0 model will offer a larger space with 600 cubic meters, while the 3.0 variant will provide an impressive 1440 cubic meters. The standard life habitat can support 4 crew members on long-duration missions, and up to 12 crew members for shorter periods. With projects like Orbital Reef, we are getting closer to living and working beyond Earth's atmosphere. In space exploration, significant moments occur when crew members experience transitions. One such moment is the modular nature of the habitat, allowing for additional components and accommodating more crew members. The vestibule acts as a connector between segments. The first full-scale test of this habitat took place in Huntsville, Alabama, with support from NASA. Sean, the Senior Director of Engineering and Chief Technologist of Earth Space Systems, expressed satisfaction after the test. The team has worked tirelessly for 2 years, collaborating with key suppliers and partners like Sierra Space. This collaboration has propelled the technology forward, aiming for lower orbit and beyond. Sierra Space believes the adaptability of the life habitat is remarkable. It can accommodate various businesses, from semiconductor manufacturing to microgravity research. The habitat takes advantage of zero-gravity conditions, providing an optimal environment for experiments and processes. With its volume, power, and data capabilities, Sierra Space is confident in its suitability for extended human habitation in lower orbit and long-duration voyages. They are setting the stage for the future of space exploration. Years ago, Sierra Space constructed a full-scale replica of a habitat, complete with interior furnishings and various equipment, that would be found on an actual mission. In an image of the second floor, you can observe a crew work area with computers and shelving. The floor and ceiling are securely in place, likely using sectional pieces that can be launched in a compact format for assembly in space. While the main habitat is inflatable, almost everything inside it is not. This means that space-efficient equipment and necessary structures are required to fill the space. Another image showcases Sierra Space's impressive Astro Garden near the access hatch. Moving up to the third floor, you get a glimpse of the crew living area and the galley table, which highlights the ample space available once in space. All the air and water needed for survival would be delivered by logistics carriers to the habitat and stored until required. The life habitat is equipped with life support systems that regulate air pressure, temperature, humidity, and oxygen levels. These systems also recycle some of the air and water to minimize the amount that needs to be delivered. In terms of size, the habitat can be launched on the Space Launch System rocket, as it expands only once it's in orbit, making transportation easier and less expensive. Sierra Space recently completed the most significant life habitat test in the company's history. With this milestone achieved, they plan to intensify testing with both sub- and full-scale habitats until the system is ready for space. That's it for today's episode. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Please let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Your feedback is very important to us, because it helps us make better videos for you, so thank you very much and we hope to see you again next time.